So I was asking the organizer yesterday if I can give a talk on how to crack coding interviews or something like that. So he said, that's fine. So amazing crowd, amazing presentations. And I'm pretty sure only few of you will be interested in cracking the coding interviews of big companies like Google or Amazon or PayPal for that matter. So I'm working for Google for the last 9 months. I will try to share only my experience on how I was able to crack this Google interview. So it was a dream for me when Sundar Pichai became the CEO of Google that I should be part of Google. Because it's a big thing. It's a big thing that, like Steve Jobs says, some people can ignore you, but I'm sorry, some people can hate you, but they cannot ignore you. Google is that big of a thing. So I wanted to be a part of Google when I was in my third year. I right now have 7 years, 6 years of experience. So a 7 year dream was achieved last year. So the path I took was, so when I passed out, my CGPA is 6.8. Needless to say, no big company will be interested in a 6.8 CGPA guy from EC. I'm not from CS background, so I'm from EC. So, however, I managed to join some campus placement company, which is a .NET based company. And you know, after getting in there, I was very, very, what do we say? I had a lot of zeal on not continue to work there, but get into some good company, good bigger company, because the pay is very low there. I'm totally frustrated every time. And I was on bench literally for about 9 months. So these 9 months time has crushed my, what do we say, the zeal for, you know, working there, whatever you call it. I was totally frustrated. So I was able to get into touch with a friend of mine who was into Morgan Stanley in Bangalore. And he's the kind of a CS pro in the college. He's from mechanical, but he used to give this 1 hour talks every day in the evening in the college. And there's a lot of fan following for him, for his, you know, the way he teaches, the way he codes, and all the campus websites are developed by him. So I went behind him and I asked him, so come on, please give me guidance. I don't want to continue working in this small company. I don't like this. Also, that's a service company. So service company, you know how service company works, right? Somebody sits somewhere in the US. They come evening at about 7:30 or 8 in the night and start giving us tasks. Our whole day will be wondering what to do. And at 7 p.m. in the night, they come and they start giving tasks. And day starts, and they expect us to start our day then. Oh, come on, what do you do? Why would you want to go home, do this, do that, it will finish, and such stuff. So added to all this, I mean, all these situations made me think about moving to one product company first. If it's a product company, why not big companies like Google or Amazon? So I asked him, he gave me some guidance like prepare data structures and algorithms, the things for big company interviews. So that's what he told. So I didn't really know what data structures and algorithms by the time I got a coding job. So to get started, I went to NPTEL website, Nash. It's NPTEL, so NPTEL. What they do is, they record all their lectures, put them on their website. So I chose three topics, DSA 1, DSA 2. DSA meaning data structures and algorithms. DSA 1, DSA 2, OS and DBMS, four courses. Each of them spanning about 44 lectures, and each lecture is about 50 minutes. Like I was saying, I was on bench for about 9 months in my initial days. My colleague, my friend, was totally, what do we say? I was on bench, he was nagging a lot. Why are we like this? And he's not very fine with the fact that he was on bench. But I used that as an opportunity to finish the four courses that are there at the hand. Each 50 minute video took like 2.5 to 3 hours for me to complete. Because you know, 6.8 CGPA guy will always open 9gag or Facebook and keep browsing the internet rather than concentrate. That's the kind of person I was. And I'm ready to accept that also. So yeah, it took about 3 hours, 4 hours, and every damn lesson, every damn lecture, I had running notes for myself, and this took about 6 months to complete all the four courses. Then after the courses, the theory is over. Where do I practice? If I'm in college, maybe the assignments, if I'm a CSC student in college, the assignments that the lecturers have given would have helped me to ramp up all the topics that were there. But that's not the case for me. I'm in a company. And once in every 1 month or 2 months, my tech lead comes and he keeps saying, So they used to give some things for us to read meanwhile. So every... Okay, so looks like time's up. I'll cut short it. So yeah. So I had these running notes. And to help me prepare, to help me revise all the topics, I went to Geeks for preparation. So only five things that I followed: the DSA courses, OS DBMS courses, and Geeks for Geeks. This I did for about 3 to 4 years. Then started giving interviews again. I got into Amazon. Amazon was all about dynamic programming in the first round. I don't clear it. They don't, I mean, I'm not good at dynamic programming. Later I started giving interviews to Salesforce, etc. Finally landed at Google. Few things I learned, few things to take home. Don't stop giving interviews. For big companies, they don't care what technology you have already worked on. They're technology agnostic. So all they care is whether you have fundamentals that are there. So if your dream is to land in a big company, make sure you have fundamentals. Fundamentals like knowledge about arrays, lists, strings, runtime, sorting, O of N notation, stuff like that. And then every company will ask you one or two design questions. Your experience, your 2 years or 3 years experience should help you solve those questions.